Hi, this is Mato. Welcome to my online chess lecture. In this video, I will show you a game between Ian Nepomniachtchi and Etienne Bakro. This is a game from Chess Olympiad, played in Batumi, Georgia, in 2018. Ian Nepomniachtchi had white pieces and he started with knight to f3. Very flexible move. d5, and now e3. A bit unusual start. A bit quiet. Have you heard of saying that early morning can tell you what kind of a day you are going to have? Well, it doesn't apply here. It will not be a quiet game. It will be a wild, wild one. The game continued. Knight to f6. c4. e6. Knight to c3. Bishop to e7. b3, intending bishop to b2. Bakro castled kingside, bishop to b2, c5, the standard move, c takes on d5, the standard move too. Black to move. Black has to decide how to capture, with a pawn or with a knight. Knight takes on d5 was played. E takes on d5 is played a bit more often. Knight to d5. This is discouraging queen to c2. White to move. How would you continue? Ian Nepomniachtchi played h4 in the style of legendary Alexander Alekhin. However, Nepomniachtchi is first to play this move in this position. b6, queen to b1, not queen to c2 because the knight can attack the queen with knight to b4. White queen is now eyeing h7 square, and you can see that the plan is to play knight to g5 at some stage of the game. That is why h4 is played. Black to move. h6. Perhaps Bakro later wished that he played another move instead. White to move. How will you continue? I think g4 is asking to be played. g4 was played. So you can see that h6 by black only helped white to reach black king sooner. Bishop to b7, x-raying the rook on h1. What is the best spot for the rook? Would you play rook to h3 or rook to g1, lining the rook with the black king? Nepomniachtchi played rook to h3. This is an excellent move, defending the knight and staying on the h-file. Let's take it back. What's wrong with rook to g1? Well, if rook to g1, then knight takes on c3, and black is winning. Back to our game. Rook to h3, knight to d7, g5. White has a serious attack going at move 12. Black to move. h5 was played, keeping the file closed. Seems like a lesser evil, but the pawn on h5 may become an easy target. Let's take it back. H takes on g5 is even worse. One line goes like this. Knight takes on d5. Bishop takes on d5. H takes on g5. White is threatening queen to h7, checkmate. f5. Pawn takes pawn en passant. Bishop takes on f6. And now, white can play queen to h7, check, or knight to g5. Knight to g5 is more precise. But let's first see what's wrong with queen to h7. It's not that it's wrong, just that other move is better. After check, king to f7, and now after knight to g5, black does not take the knight. King goes to e8. White is still better. Let's go back. If knight goes first to g5, then black will take, and then queen goes to h7, check, king to f7. Can you see now? g7. Pawn is not defended. Queen takes on g7, check. King to e8. Queen to g6, check. Rook to f7. Rook to h8. King to e7. Queen takes on g5. White is winning. So this would happen if, in this position, black captured the pawn. h5 was played. Bishop to d3. Knight to b4, attacking the bishop. Defending the pawn, on h5 is not a good idea. One line goes like this: bishop takes on g6, and if pawn takes on g6, queen takes on g6, check, king to h8, knight takes on d5, check, white is winning. Back to our game. Knight to b4, bishop to h7, check, king to h8, bishop to e4, knight to d5. You know what is interesting about this position? On the surface, it looks like that it is equal. But black's position is much more difficult to play, because black king is not safe. And as you can see, white king is quite safe where it is. The game continued. Knight to e2, intending at some stage knight to f4. f5. Bishop to d6 should have been considered. f5. Pawn takes pawn en passant. Knight on 7 takes on f6. How about g takes on f6, preventing knight to g5? One line goes like this: bishop takes on d5, bishop takes on d5, knight to g5, and white is winning. Back to our game. Knight from 7 to f6, knight to g5. This knight was waiting all his life to jump to g5 square. Knight takes on e4. Queen takes on e4, threatening checkmate. Bishop takes on g5 was played. H takes on g5. Knight to f4. Is it going to be bishop for rook? Maybe. How would you continue? Nepomniachtchi played queen takes on b7. And now, instead of knight takes rook, knight to d3 check. Why? What's wrong with knight takes on h3? Well, this move has a tiny, tiny downside. Can you see the downside? This is the downside. Queen takes on g7, checkmate. Back to our game. Knight to d3, check. Attacking the bishop and the pawn on f2. King to f1. Knight takes bishop. How about rook takes on f2, check? Is that better? One line goes like this: king to g1. And black has a problem to solve. Queen takes on g7, checkmate. If e5, then bishop takes on e5, knight takes on e5. Well, first check, and after king to g8, king takes on f2 is one ordinary line, and a fancy one is queen to h1, and if rook moves to a safe spot, then check, and white wins black queen. Back to our game. Knight to b2. Well, the black pawn on g7 is safer now, but there are other tiny problems, like the pawn on h5. Rook takes on h5 was played. Check. King to g8. White played a move when black resigned. What would you do? Yeah, Nepomniachtchi played g6. Bakro resigned. If, for example, knight to d3, then check, and after king takes rook, queen to h1, check, king to g8, queen to h7, checkmate. Let's go back. If the best move is played, rook to f6, then queen to h1, then rook takes on g6, rook to h8, check, wins the queen. After rook takes on d8, let's play a few more moves. Knight to f4, attacking the rook, rook to f6, king to e2, king to g8, moving to safety, then rook to b1 or rook to g1. Rook to b1 wins the knight. I guess we can stop here. This game won the brilliancy prize in the round 11. What do you think of this game? And that is all. I hope that you enjoyed watching this video. I wish you good luck with your chess, and bye for now.